Sir Topham Hatt's railway was busier than ever. More and more people were arriving from all over to see the sights. The engines found the work to be exhausting. Even Gordon was growing tired. "I say, you engines," he sighed one night, "you ought to be picking up the slack around here." "What do you mean?" demanded James indignantly. "The tourist trains. They're getting in my way of rest between trips with the express." James snorted. "Maybe," suggested Henry innocently, "if you didn't crawl along the line, you'd have time for a rest." "I have to go slow," Gordon replied. "The passengers demand we do so." "I'm an express engine," he went on, "not some tourist attraction." Henry said no more, but Donald and Douglas had lost patience. "If you're so tired," said Donald sharply, "why don't you stop your moaning and get some sleep?" "Aye," agreed Douglas, "you're not the only one who's tired." Gordon said nothing after that. Next day, it was James's turn to take the first tourist train. He arrived at Vickerstown and found the platform deserted. "Rosie," he inquired, "where are the coaches? Where are the passengers? Has the train been canceled?" "Your train?" "Yes. There's a special coming from the Bluebell Railway to our island." James was about to reply when he heard an old familiar whistle. "Is that who I think it is?" "That it is, James," said Stepney. "It's good to be back." "Stepney," cried James, "it's good to see you again. But if I may, why are you here?" "To help with the tourists, of course. Sir Topham Hatt called my controller and asked if he could spare me to help out for a few days. So my controller asked me if I'd return, and I was glad to agree. I've certainly missed your island."
"So have I," came a voice.
"Old Slow Coach," cried James. "But Thomas and Percy told me that you were turned into a home for the workmen."
"I was," she replied, "but the Bluebell Railway bought me, and now I work every day with Stepney carrying passengers up and down the line."
James was very impressed. The passengers who had arrived on Stepney's train wanted to look around in Vickerstown for a while. Stepney was moved on to an empty platform and had to wait around as the passengers enjoyed the station. He soon grew bored, but found it nice to see his old friends. At last, Stepney was able to set off. He puffed down the line, but soon had to stop at Ulfstead Station.
"Look at the castle!" cried the passengers. Millie was on the line above.
"I can give you all a tour if you like," she called.
The passengers quickly scrambled to the platform. Millie gave a cheerful whistle to Stepney and hurried away.
"Hello, down there!" called Stephen. "Who are you?"
"I'm Stepney," he replied. "I've never seen an engine like you before."
"Lots of people say that. I'm an old engine, one of the first ever built."
Stepney was amazed. He enjoyed talking to Stephen and was sorry when it was time to go. Stepney continued slowly along the line. He stopped at every station and had to wait while the passengers looked around. He puffed over to the sheds for a rest. There, Stepney shunted Old Slowcoach into a siding and went over to the water tower for a drink.
"You know," he said to Old Slowcoach, "it would be nice for some real work right about now."
"What do you mean?" she asked. "You are doing real work. I mean, fast work. Heavy work. You know, like an express. Or a goods train."
"But you're meant to take tourist trains. It's what you do."
Stepney wheezed steam in disgust. "I do it every day on the Bluebell Railway," he sighed. "I hoped coming here would allow me to do something different. I feel like I'm in a rut." Just then, two blue engines puffed into the junction with an enormous line of trucks.
"Well done, Fergus," puffed Timothy. "Only three more trains."
Fergus sighed. He and Timothy were exhausted. "Some easy work would be nice right about now," he said.
"I agree," said Timothy.
Little did they know, that's just what they were about to get. Stepney had been listening intently from the siding.
"Hello," he said. The two engines jumped and looked over towards him. "Would you like to pull some tourist trains?"
"I'd love to," sighed Fergus, "but we have to take these trucks to Vickerstown."
"Never mind about that. I'll handle the trucks."
Timothy and Fergus were surprised.
"You want to pull trucks?" asked Timothy.
"Sure," said Stepney. "It'd be a nice change."
The two engines weren't thoroughly convinced.
"I'll tell you what," he continued. "Why don't I finish this tour and meet you in Vickerstown? I'm sure by then you'll want to take my trains."
Fergus and Timothy agreed. It wasn't long until Stepney pulled into Vickerstown and found the two engines waiting.
"So, what do you say?" he asked again.
"Well," said Timothy, "you don't seem to be as tired as we are."
"Your work does look easier," added Fergus. Just then the passengers stepped out of Old Slowcoach.
"Oh," they cried, "what unusual engines!"
The passengers all looked in wonder at Timothy's oil tank and side plates. Then they saw Fergus's flywheel and big driving wheels. The passengers asked them all sorts of questions and even took their photograph. The two engines were flattered.
"So?" asked Stepney.
The two engines beamed. The stationmaster and drivers all agreed to the switch going ahead. Timothy took some passengers in the Old Slowcoach, while Fergus took the others in some branch line coaches. Stepney headed up to the quarry with some empty trucks. He shunted the trucks with ease, and they gave him no trouble. Even Bill and Ben stayed out of his way. Stepney soon had a full train and hurried away down the line. He passed engines as he went, but didn't have time to stop and say hello. The days seemed to fly by. It was evening when Stepney was ready with his last train. He was feeling exhausted. "You've been a big help today," said Mavis as she drew alongside.
"Not a problem at all," said Stepney. "It's nice to help out."
Stepney puffed wearily into the station, where he found Fergus and Timothy waiting.
"Did you enjoy your day?" they asked.
"Yes," panted Stepney, "but it was exhausting. I didn't have time for a rest or a friendly chat. It's hard work."
"It is indeed," said Fergus, "but I wouldn't trade it for the world."
"Quite right, Fergus," said Timothy. "Tourist trains are nice and all, but I much prefer the hustle and bustle of the quarry."
"You're welcome to it," Stepney puffed. "I'll take my tourist trains any day. That's the kind of work I look forward to."
"But I thought it wasn't real work," remarked Old Slowcoach. Stepney laughed.
"It is real work. It's just different work. But it is real indeed."
The next day, Stepney was back to his normal routine. He stopped at all the stations and talked to every engine who had the time. I think it's safe to say that he's glad to be doing the same job again. Wouldn't you?